you've seen the new look, and you've heard the new sound. Now the Continental Twist, baby, is in your town. Sam, I'm gonna go throw these kids out, believe me.
What good will that do?
Well, you kidding? We gotta get some paying customers in here.
Man, if you roughing them kids up, you're gonna get the cops in here.
Well, what do you want me to do? Will you please tell me?
Well, why don't you do a little show for them and soften them up?
Those hardheads.
Sure, try it out, Chief.
Okay, Einstein, we'll try it your way. One, two, three.
When you're smiling,
and the whole world smiles with you. When you're laughing.
I'm gonna get some fresh air. Don't anybody leave.
And the sun will come a shining through. And when you're crying, you bring on the rain. Have your sign, be happy again. When you're smiling, keep on smiling, and the whole world will smile with you. I'm doodly up to do my world to go. I'm doodly up to do my world to go. Your eyes, and your eyes are blue, your kisses too. I never knew what there's to do. I can't believe that you're in love with me.
Shoo-be-doo-be.
You're telling everyone I know I'm on your mind. Each place you go, I can't believe that you're in love with me.
Shoo-be-doo-be.
Baby, I have always praised you so. Love, your eyes. I can't believe that you're in love with me. Because I can't give you anything but love. Baby, that's the only thing I'm ready of. Baby, dream wild, scheme of life, you're sure to find happiness.
mean?
Now you got him, Chief. Keep swinging.
Let's make him twist.
Yeah.
Well, all right. Okay. You win. I'm in love with you. Well, all right. Okay. You win. Baby, what can I do? I'll do anything you say. Just gotta be that way. I love you and it won't be hard to do. Well, all right, okay, you win. I'm in love with you. Well, all right, okay, you win. Baby, what can I do? I'll do anything you say. It is just gonna be that way. Like, I love you, and it won't be hard to do, baby. Well, all right. Okay. Are you with me? I'm in love with you. Well, all right. Okay. You win. Baby, what can I do?
That doesn't sound. Look, what do you want? You come in here every night with this mob. You don't dance. You take up all the tables. No other people can come in. Now, what do you want from me?
What? Is this the way you treat your customers, Mr. Evans?
Miss Clunker.
I'd like to see you in your office. It's important.
Play something, Sam. Well, Miss Quonka, what can I do for you?
Miss Watson, may I have the book? According to our records, Mr. Evans, you have not paid rent for 2 months. I'm surprised Miss Watson didn't tell me of it, but I happened to check it myself. As you know, it was against my better judgment to rent this property to you. I personally felt that your music was vulgar and would attract a low type of clientele.
But
I haven't finished. The upper floor of this building is occupied by an art gallery, and the owner, Mr. Arturo, complains of the noise.
My music ain't noise. Besides, I don't complain about the noise he makes. You see what I mean? Believe me, Miss Clunker, I know we'll make it here. All I gotta do is to figure out some kind of way to keep the kids out of the joint. I mean the club. This dance has got to catch on. We'll be turning customers away.
Why would anyone be here this time of night?
Because it's a nightclub, not a day club.
Not you, Miss Evans. Mr. Arturo.
It's impossible to paint under such conditions.
Julius, will you please get started on the other picture? I have a very rich Argentinian who wants that.
Yeah. But what happens if we get caught?
Let me worry about that. Now, come on, get on with it.
Yeah. Let's wait until they close up. Even the Duchess of Verona is doing the twist.
I'm expecting another masterpiece tonight, and I want you to get right on it.
Then please stop that verfluchte music.
By next week, it'll be stopped altogether.
Yes, I hope so.
My suggestion to you is not to let them in.
Well, there's a city ordinance which states a public place must be open to everyone.
That's right. I can't do nothing. They don't cause no trouble. But they sit there and take up all the tables that the paying customers would use.
That's your problem, Mr. Evans. I'm going to see Mr. Arturo about that noise. Meet me outside in 5 minutes, Jenny.
Yes, Miss Clunker.
Listen, babe, you're going to have to stop working that night for that old batten. Give me a little time.
Oh, Miss Clunk is a very nice woman.
Yeah, finally she's going to throw me out of the place.
Nobody's going to throw you out. What we have to do is to find out who's sending those kids and stop them.
That little punk that just sits there, I'm going to rap it.
You're going to rap no one. That would give Miss Clunk and who's ever against you a perfect excuse to close the place up.
I don't understand. He keeps bugging me. What, am I a louse or something?
Louis Evans is a louse, if you'll excuse the expression. That barbarian has the nerve to say we make too much noise.
What are you doing here at this time of night, Mr. Arturo? The gallery closes at 6 o'clock.
Well, at night we clean and restore the paintings. Mr. Kleinfort works for a different gallery during the day, and I can afford him only on a part-time basis.
Well, I do wish he didn't have to use that air compressor. This wasn't meant to be a factory.
My establishment is an art gallery. And if you have to choose between that noise from downstairs and these world-famous paintings,
oh,
well...
I didn't mean that. I think your gallery lends an air of dignity to my building.
Well, thank you. And now if we can remove that blight from downstairs...
I'm positive Mr. Evans will be out of there by the end of the week.
Maybe you could rent it to a nice, quiet continental restaurant.
That would be very nice.
Miss Clunker, if you haven't had dinner, I would be honored if we might dine together.
Oh, well, why, thank you. I would love to. But I'm dining with my secretary, Miss Watson. It's the servants' night out.
Well, why can't both you charming ladies have dinner with me?
Oh, I'm sure that would be all right. I'll tell her.
Excellent. Now, if you'll excuse me for a moment, I must give Mr. Kleinfort some last-minute instructions.
I'll just look at your lovely paintings.
Why don't you get rid of that old banshee? If she finds out what we are doing, we both go to drink.
Vincent, how would you and the boys like to pick up a little merchandise for me tonight? From the Clunker Mansion.
Oh, good evening. Are you stationed here every night?
Until they close.
Why?
Lady, all I know is I get an order. This is my beat until further notice, and that's it. I make sure the place isn't overcrowded, and they don't create a disturbance.
Well, who's they?
Those kids in there. That's the same social club. They come here every night.
Well, do you do this with every club in town?
Only when we get a complaint.
Well, who complained about the place?
They don't tell me anything, lady. Excuse me, I've got a check.
Jenny, we're being taken to dinner by Mr. Archer.
How charming.
Shall we?
It's just the idea that it has to finish some kind of way.
Now, that's pretty, Chief. Why don't you keep it in?
Well, you see, Sam, when you get to the ending of the thing, I have a... I'm sorry, folks. We're not opening. We don't allow anybody in here while we're rehearsing.
Chief, that's a friend of mine.
Well, come right in.
Sam, you know I don't like anybody around while we're rehearsing.
Yeah, but this is special, Chief. How'd you like to make this the most popular club in town?
You kidding or something?
No, he can get the people in here and teach them how to twist.
Who's this, Arthur Murray?
No, but he's got a shortcut method, and he teaches them, and they learn like that.
Well, I'd like to see it.
Dick, why don't you show him what I'm talking about on the floor?
I'd be happy to. Have you got a towel I can borrow?
Hey, give me that towel, Bobby. Go right ahead.
Thank you. Thank you. Now, you take your feet. Now, you put your left foot here and your right foot here. That way you got your balance, see? Now, you take the towel and you put it right around the waist. Now, you pretend like you just got out of the shower. And you're going to dry yourself off. Now, dry. That's it. That's it. Just keep it dry. Now, a little bigger. Over this way. That. See? Now, if you give us a little music, we'll show you how the twist is done.
Go ahead. One, two, three. Now, you're hired. You can start tonight.
Hey, thank you, Mr. Evans. Thank you.
That's okay. Just be sure you're on time.
See? What did I tell you?
Sam, you're a genius. Come on, we got some work to do, man. Bobby, ring the bell.
Hello there, baby! Yeah, this is me, the big horn talker, baby. Do I what? Do I who? Oh, yeah, baby. Sure. You know what I like. Chintilly lace and a pretty face. A ponytail, a hanging down. A wiggle in a walk and a giggle in a talk. Lord, makes the world go round, round, round. There ain't nothing in the world like a big eye gal. It makes me act so funny. Spend my money, make me feel real loose like a long-necked goose. Ah, baby, that's what I like. What's that, sugar? But, baby! Yeah, darling. Yeah! You know what I like? Chintilly lace and a pretty face. A ponytail, a hanging down. A wiggle and a walk and a giggle and a talk. Lord, makes the world go round, round, round. There ain't nothing in the world like a big eyed gal. It makes me act so funny. Spend my money, make me feel real loose like a long neck goose. Oh, baby, that's what I like. What's that, sugar? Want me to meet you at 8 and don't be late? But I done told you, baby, I ain't got no money. Uh-uh. Oh, you gonna come up a little something? You know what I like. Chantilly lace and a pretty face. A ponytail, a hanging down. A wiggle and a walk and a giggle and a talk. Lord, make the world go round, round, round. There ain't nothing in the world like a big-eyed gal. It makes me act so funny. Spend my money, make me feel real loose like a long-necked goose. Oh, baby, that's what I like. There ain't nothing in the world like a big-eyed gal. It makes me act so funny. Spend my money, make me feel real loose like a long-necked goose. Oh, baby, that's what I like.
How was that, Chief?
Well, you can do better, Sam.
But it was only a rehearsal.
But do it once more, just for me, okay?
Okay, one more time.
Wait a minute. Hold it, Sam. You and the boys take a little rest.
Okay.
Hiya, baby. I thought you were coming back last night after that old beauty fed you.
Oh, Louis, didn't you read the paper this morning?
I read them all. Everybody picks Charlie Horse in the fifth race.
Well, here it is on the front page. Miss Plunkett's home was robbed last night. We got home around 11 and found the library door forced open and the painting gone.
So what's all the fuss? She'll buy another one.
The Lady Elaine is worth $300,000.
That's a fine lady.
Now do you understand why I didn't return last night? Oh, the police were all over the place until 3 this morning.
There's no cops around now. Lay a little one right on the little cheek.
There was something else.
Yeah, tell me.
I just came from the police station.
Oh.
They told me who the kids are. They're bugging you every night.
Sure, they're busy.
Come on, you didn't hear me. I said the police told me who the kids are and where they come from.
I hear you. Come here, sweetheart.
Well, don't you want to keep them out? Don't you want to save your club?
How am I going to keep them out?
Well, I thought maybe we could go down there and talk to them and convince them not to come in.
That's a good idea. I'll take Sam and all the boys, and we'll go down and we'll convince them.
You and I will go alone, and there'll be no roughhouse.
All we're going to do is talk to them.
Right. All we're going to do is talk to them. We. You and I.
Oh, baby, don't you trust me, honey.
I love you, Louis. You're the sweetest man I know, but you've got one of the worst tempers I've seen.
Me?
Come on, I'm going down to the club, and you're welcome to come along.
Wait for celery eyes, baby.
Every day, I went to a party at the village lane. The kids were playing a crazy game. But a cute little billy goat twisted by. He walked right up and gave her the eye. Stand that twisting, darling. Don't let her get away. Come on. Stand that twisting, darling. Don't let her get away. Come on. Now. Potential filly was a thrill to me. Take that twisting, dolly. Better get away, come on. Take that twisting, dolly. Don't let her get away, come on. Now, take that twisting, dolly. Make her love you every day. Skipping up and down, twisting all around. Oh, baby, twist, baby. Like a rubber ball. Tag you mine and all mine. Cute little filly, that's the play. Can really steal your heart away. But once you tag them and tag them right, you fill your heart with hey, that twist and dolly. Don't let her get away, come on. Tag that twist and dolly. Don't let her get away, come on. Now, tag that twist and dolly. I'll make all of you every day.
Well, how about one more number, then we start the meeting?
Hey, you!
Oh, Mr. Evans, this is a pleasure, having you visit us.
Oh, Riffy, the police told us where we could find you. Oh, we just wanted to talk.
We ain't looking for trouble.
Yeah, but you already got trouble, right, Mr. Evans?
I don't understand. I saw you dancing to Louis' music, so you must enjoy it.
Lady, like, we dig it the most.
You dig my music? How come you hate me?
Well, it's nothing personal, Mr. Evans. It's just a matter of business.
Oh, you mean somebody's paying you to sit there?
Man, that's the lowest. If I knew who it was, I'd rap that guy.
Murphy, can we talk to you privately, please?
I got a summit meeting. Wait outside. You wanted to talk, so talk.
Well, we're not going to ask you who's paying you to do this to Mr. Evans, because I know you have much too much integrity to tell us.
Try him.
He's only joking.
How come no one's laughing?
I thought it was very funny.
Well, I don't.
Please, Louis. Now, let's get on with the discussion. Well, now, since we don't want to know who the other party is, we can discuss his deal, can't we?
Yeah, we can talk about the deal. What do you want to know?
Well, if the deal isn't too stiff, maybe we could come up to it, or perhaps we could even better it.
I see. You want me to double-cross a client.
Oh, no, no. It isn't that. We'd just like to bid on your services in a straight, business-like manner.
How do you know it won't be out of line?
We'll never know unless you let me handle this.
Minutes of the last meeting. Old business, new... here it is. Mr. X. Mr. X wants the entire membership to show up at Mr. Louis Evans' club every night from the time it opens until the time it closes. One, he agrees to pay the cover but is to be charged for nothing more. Two, every member is to be paid $1 a night. Three, they must never dance. Four, when the club closes for good, Mr. X agrees to purchase jackets for the entire membership. Said jackets to be of any design the Saints want.
Well, good. We can better it.
Hold it. How do you know we can?
Louis.
We can.
What's your deal?
We'll donate the jackets.
Date of delivery?
You can have them today.
Oh, now we're taking a cash loss by not coming down to the club.
Well, Mr. Evans will donate $200 to the Saints Treasury.
200 clams?
200 clams. Dollars. Now, come on, Louis. Write out a check for $400. 200 for the Saints Treasury and 200 as a deposit on the jacket.
Oh, there's one other matter. What if some of us want to come down to the club to see the show?
Oh, you're welcome anytime.
Yeah, as long as you don't come all together, all at the same time on the same night.
Fair enough. Oh, and there's one other thing. Well, when we come, we don't want to wear ties. We want to wear the jackets you're donating.
Anytime. It's a pleasure to do business with a pro.
Don't forget to come and see us when you get the jackets.
Yeah, and take a long time getting them made. I'm going to rush nothing.
I can hear this.
Say, man, when's the chief coming back?
Well, how should I know? How long are we going to hang around? I'm ready to leave. Somebody, are you winning?
I think I'll wait till he gets back.
You don't see him now. You'll see him at showtime. What's the big deal, Ro?
Nothing. I just had something I wanted to show him.
Put it on his desk. He'll see it when he gets in.
Man, I wanted to show him a new bit for the act.
Well, save it for tomorrow's rehearsal, huh?
Man, it's to do with the pipes. Dig this lick.
Jim, there's no sense waiting any longer. The chief probably went for a bite to eat with that chick.
Maybe you're right, Sal.
I think the chief will be hacked if we're not here when he gets back.
Don't worry. I'll straighten out any beefs.
I think I'll wait.
Are you going to go home? We're going to take the chief's car.
Man, I sure wanted to show him my new impression.
Well, royally, seriously, the chief's tired of hearing all those Nat King Cole impressions.
Hey, wait!
Sam, Rolly. Gee, honey, you shouldn't have let the cab go. The boys are gone and they took my car.
Oh, Louis, it's wonderful. Everything is all straightened out.
Yeah.
Don't you think you owe me something for handling it so well?
Yeah.
Oh, come on, you didn't hear one word that I said.
What?
I said you didn't hear one word that I said.
I'm sorry, honey. I'm trying to figure out... Who gave me the zinger?
What does it matter? It's all over with now anyway.
How do I know he won't come up with another scheme to close the place?
He won't.
He won't, right? You're going to give me a guarantee. Wait a minute. Do you know who this Mr. X is?
Well, I'm not sure.
What do you mean you're not sure? Either you do or you don't.
Stop shouting at me.
I'm shouting.
Well, stop shouting at me.
I'm sorry, honey. You're a fine lady.
You're a big, big bear.
I'm a tiger. Do you know who this Mr. X is?
I was thinking. It has to be someone who wants you out of the club.
Letitia Clunker.
Oh, no. I know every move she makes. It has to be someone much closer.
Honey, don't play games.
Well, I was thinking. Now, I'm not sure, but maybe it's Mr. Otoro.
That creep. Yeah, he's the one. I'm not good enough for him. Well, when I see him, I'll wrap it.
You'll do nothing of the sort.
You think I can't?
I know you can, but if you hit him or anyone else, they'll take away your club license in a second. They're very strict about performers never being arrested. Now, when you meet him, you'll be very civil, you'll shake hands, and act like you don't suspect a thing.
How come you want me to be so nice to him?
I just want you to be careful. I want you to knock him off his guard.
I'd like to knock him off his feet.
Listen to me. I want you to meet with him, shake hands, and act friendly.
Oh, come on off of it, honey.
No, really. It's the only way to beat him at his own game.
Are you putting me on or something?
No, I want you to act friendly.
Well, I don't know what I...
Well, I want you to do it for me, will you?
Okay, I'll do it. But you'll bring Arturo down here. I ain't going up there. When he comes down, I'll shake hands with him. And I'll promise never to complain about his noise.
And I'll make sure he promises never to complain about your music.
Solid.
Nothing about the Saints.
Nothing.
I'll go up the back stairs.
I'll be a gentleman. When he comes down, I'll say, Mr. Arturo, how do you do? I'll stick out my hand, and we'll shake.
Vincent? Arturo. Well, I see your little exploit made the front pages. Well, I'm looking forward to seeing the Lady Elaine tonight. What do you mean you're not bringing her over? Look, the longer we keep around, the more chances we're taking. Well, look, Julius and I will be over for her. Well, I don't know just when, but just stay there, right? Miss Watson. Oh, this is a pleasant surprise.
Oh, Mr. Arturo, I don't know quite where to begin.
Oh, I know the painting. It was a great loss, but I'm sure the police will be able to...
It's not the painting. It's about Mr. Evans.
Oh, well, I trust you agree with Miss Clunker and me about getting rid of him.
Mr. Arturo, let me assure you that Mr. Evans will remain here as long as he wants to.
Oh. Well, just what did you want to see me about?
I'd like to know if you know Riffy and his Social Saints Club.
Is this a membership drive?
I have every reason to believe that you hired them to fill the place.
I shan't dignify that accusation with a reply.
Although why you want to get rid of Mr. Evans is beyond me.
Whatever gave you that idea? I have nothing against Mr. Evans. True, I don't appreciate his music, but I certainly wouldn't put him out of business.
Would you tell Mr. Evans that?
Of course.
Would you come with me right now?
Well, there's nobody else in the shop.
Oh, it'll only take a minute.
Well, I...
And it would be to everyone's advantage if you and Mr. Evans were friendly.
Well, perhaps you're right.
Good.
That's what I'll do. I'll be friendly. But supposing when I stick my hand out, he don't take my hand. I'm not good enough for that bum. Picture that. My girl walking upstairs and bringing him down here, and he's gonna say to me, and this is the bum that sent these kids in here that lost this place up. I can't get the paying customers in. I won't stand for it. I'll take that bum apart.
Louis, take Mr. Arturo.
Why, you freak.
Louis.
I'd like to speak to Miss Watson, please.
I'm sorry, sir. Miss Watson is indisposed.
Well, tell her it's me.
Who is me?
Who is me? What kind of English is that? Who is me? It's who is I. And I am Mr. Louis Evans.
I'm sorry, Mr. Evans, but Miss Watson is especially indisposed to you.
Ladies and gentlemen, now we want you all to relax a little bit and have a little taste, and I'll be right back.
Catch a knock?
What are you kidding, man?
I'm sorry, Sam.
That's all right, Chief. Man, I come in to tell you that place outside is jumping, and them people are coming on like gangbusters, man.
Crazy.
Oh, man, if I couldn't appear in my own place, I know it would be a drag, but we're going to straighten it out.
That's why I'm bug, right?
Well, if I got my license lifted because I wrapped somebody in a mile, I'd be bug, too.
You're very bright, Sam.
Jenny?
Jenny.
Oh, well, why don't you get her on the pipe? Maybe if I call her, she'll talk to me, huh?
Hold it, John Alden. She'll talk to me, but only after I apologize for that big square upset.
Well, that's beautiful, and then he might withdraw the charges, and everything will be groovy. Why don't you do that, man? Call him.
I did, man, but the cab cut out. The place is closed.
Listen, Chief, they just came back. Careful.
I'll talk to him tomorrow.
No, go do it now, and then Jenny will talk to you.
Sam, go on. Please, let me handle this. Go ahead, man. The place is jumping. Go ahead.
Easy now.
It's a crime to have to paint over her.
Yeah, but it's a bigger crime if they find her here. Besides, when they strip off my painting, she'll be just as good as new.
Come on. Hurry up.
I know what I'll do. I'll go upstairs and I'll stick up my hand and I'll say, Mr. Arturo, I'd like to apologize. No, the last time I did that, I belted that cat. I'll just go up and ad lib the apology. Yeah, that I'll do.
Please forgive me, Helena.
Get on with it.
This would lead to murder.
Shut up, you fool.
What are we going to do?
You're going to finish covering that painting, and I'm going to call the police.
Are you out of here for similar to mind? Let's get out of here.
I'm going to call the police and charge our friend here with breaking and entering. I'll say he tried to attack me again.
Well, do you think he saw the picture?
Who's going to believe a man charged with a felony? Police, I wish to report a crime.
Louis!
Hey, baby, I'm out glad to see you.
Oh. Mm-hmm. Are you all right? Well, they said you were unconscious when they brought you in.
I'm fine. But there's something I have to tell you. Something I saw.
Well, will you tell me what you were trying to do?
I was going to apologize like I promised you.
Sure, that's why you broke the door down and tried to attack him.
Are you off your wig or something?
Well, Mr. Otoro wouldn't lie. And besides, I were with you when you were going to shake hands. Remember?
Look, I walked in and now... Wait a minute. You mean you don't believe me and you believe that creep?
Well, I didn't say that.
Well, what are you saying?
Well, that you're hot-headed and you've got a vile temper and you're no gentleman.
Don't tell my Sunday school teacher.
Oh, you're hateful.
Jenny, come back here. Jenny... Come back, babe.
It's the third cell on the right.
Where's the lawyer?
Oh, he's outside signing a paper so we can bail you out.
Salad? Well, you cats better cut out because the first show starts in an hour.
See, there's no rush.
What do you mean there's no rush? I told you 1,000 times I want you to start the show on time.
Yeah, I know.
Okay, well, go ahead, blow. What's the matter with your cats? Sam?
Well, this commissioner, he came by the place and he was telling something about the rules. And,
Sam, don't hem and haw. Lay it on me straight, man.
They closed the club.
Who's they?
The cops. They said as long as you got this wrap hanging over your head, that it's going to stay closed.
But I ain't guilty of nothing.
I know your lawyers are telling it, but they said after the trial, if you're innocent, then they'll renew the license for you.
Yeah, but that's going to take months, and that clunker woman, she can cancel the lease.
Yeah, but you got Jenny pulling for you.
Which way? Y'all should have been on that scene we had this afternoon.
Yeah, I know. She told me.
When did you see her?
I didn't see her, Chief. She called me and told me about the license bit. And so I could get a lawyer.
That's a fine lady, man.
And you know it. And the first thing you better do when you get out of here is to tell her that.
That's what I'll do, the first thing, Sam.
Yeah, but there's only one problem.
What's that?
She don't want to ever see or talk to you no more.
The captain said steel bars do out of prison. Mick was a goof. He was never in one of those things. Give me a dime, Sam.
Yeah, but what if she hangs up?
Man, she was pretty hacked at me.
Why don't you let me go first?
Crazy. Hell, I'll do anything she says, Sam. And I'm dying to talk to that lady. That's a fine lady, man.
Hello?
Hello, Jenny. I'm my best pal's best gal.
I'm nobody's best gal. And if you called me up to give me that tidbit, then good night.
Now, hold it, Jenny. We just told him about the club, and he's real brought down.
Now, if he didn't have such a vile temper, he'd still have the club. Now, you can tell him from me, Sam, that I never want to see him again.
Give me that.
Sam? Sam?
Everybody knows that I love you. Everybody knows that I care. Everybody knows that I finally found the one girl who's loved I could share. Everybody knows that you still know. Everybody knows that you're mine. Everybody knows, cause they hear the sound of two lovers walking on there. When I first met you, yeah, it was hard to get you, yeah, to believe that I was a lonely guy.
A lonely guy.
Yes, my darling, I was a lonely guy.
A lonely guy.
And then an angel walked by. Everybody knows that you want me. Everybody knows I need you. Now you can stop your dreaming.
There's no need for scheming.
Cause baby, 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 everybody knows.
That's me, honey. Celery eyes. Got any more dimes? You can't split, man. I'll catch y'all later. Okay?
Well, maybe I better stick, huh?
Go ahead and blow, Sam. I got a little phoning to do, man. Straighten this lady out.
There's a Mr. Sam to see you.
Well, send him in.
Jenny, have you seen Lou? We can't find him.
Oh, Sam, I don't have time to play games. I've a lot of work to do.
Now, this is serious. The boys and I have been looking all over for him all morning.
Well, he probably went out and took a long, long walk.
Oh, look, don't you understand? He didn't come home last night. And we haven't seen him since we bailed him out of the can.
Well, that just suits me fine. And I hope I never see him again.
Oh, now listen, you don't mean that. I know you had a fight and all of that, but you know you're the only chick he really digs.
Well, what am I supposed to do? Jump with joy at that bit of news? Well, I'm telling you something, Sam. I don't dig him. Why, he's uncouth and And he's got a vile temper, and he doesn't keep his word, and oh, Sam.
Now, look, don't you worry. We'll find him.
Did you try the hospital?
Sure, we called there first this morning. He's not there. In fact, we even tried the morgue.
Oh, Sam!
Now, look, you just cool it, baby. He's all right. We just gotta find him.
Well, there were a couple of places we used to go to together.
Yeah?
I'll get my coat and we'll try it.
Oh, fine.
Oh, excuse me, Jenny. I didn't realize you had company.
Oh, this is Mr. DeAndre, the florist. We were here discussing the designs for the party tomorrow night. Miss Clunker, Mr. DeAndre.
Enchanté.
Oh, yes. We were just going to Mr. DeAndre's office for more designs.
Oh, by all means. Jenny, I just came down to tell you that I've been talking with the mayor's wife, and they're definitely coming.
Oh, wonderful, Miss Clunker.
And that's not all. They're bringing a group from the UN.
Madam, the men outside are waiting. We must go.
Oh, of course. You two run ahead.
Au revoir. What makes you think the chief would be here?
Well, I can't think of any other place to go to. Besides, we've covered every place Louis and I ever went to.
Well, you can scratch this joint. There's not a sound in here.
Well, it'll only take a minute. Louis?
Ben!
Louis!
Where you been? We've been worried. Come on there. Bye.
What's your horror, Sam?
Well, you know what they say. Two is counting and three is a drag.
Don't be so silly, Sam. We were only saying hello.
Well, I'd sure like to catch the goodbyes.
Why didn't you tell anyone where you'd be?
I was brought down, honey. I had to be alone. You were gone. We lost the club. I was in Panicsville. But there was something I had to tell you about that Artura cat. You remember the night he hit me on the head?
Oh, let's not talk about him. Listen, I think we can have your club reopened real soon.
Where? In Siberia? You don't need a license there.
Will you let the lady finish? She's got a groovy plan.
Thank you, Sam. Now, first, you're going to play at Miss Clunker's party tomorrow night.
But we don't play minuets.
Sam says you play waltzes.
Yeah, but it hurts.
Don't worry, you'll have them all doing the twist by the end of the evening.
This I gotta see.
Well, Miss Clunker's a real snob, and if we tell her it's the rage of Paris, she'll break her back trying to do it.
Who do you know from Paris that can lay that kind of line on her?
Sally, the trombonist, will put a beard on him and let him do it.
I don't even understand him when he speaks English.
That's what I mean.
Listen, he won't play at the beginning of the evening. I'll bring him in later.
I can't figure out what this has got to do with the opening of the club.
Well, the mayor will be there, and I'll talk to him, and you just play your music real sweet.
Sweet, honey? We'll have Guy Lombardo biting his fingernails.
Musician as Mr. Dondrier and have him kiss my hand. Well, really, Miss Watson, That was unforgivable. Here, this will take care of you until the end of the month. You may pack now and leave whenever it's convenient. You don't have to wait.
Enchanté.
Indeed.
Bonsoir, madame.
Bonsoir, monsieur.
Enchanté.
How dare you?
Madame, the United Nations will hear about this.
Patricia.
Oh, yes, Mr. Mayor.
Didn't I see Mr. Dubois of the French delegation a moment ago? Where is he?
Oh, I think he left something in his car, yeah. Oh, Jenny. Jenny will see that he gets right back. Oh, Jenny, dear. I just made a terrible mistake. I slapped the French delegate and he left. Please get him back here.
Miss Clunky, you just fired me.
Well, I'm just hiring you again. Now go, now. He'll be right back, Mr. Mayor.
Well, he'll be missing one of the best parties of the year if he isn't.
Do you think you'll be running for re-election next year?
No, I came here to enjoy myself and not talk business with you. Now I'll ask you a question. How would you like to dance with me?
I'd love to. Oh, I see my secretary's bringing Monsieur Dubois back.
I'm afraid Monsieur Dubois had to leave in a hurry. However, Monsieur Bergeon is able to remain.
Monsieur.
Enchanté.
It's a shame Monsieur Dubois had to leave. Do you find our dancing amusing, monsieur?
No. It's just that it's your style of dancing.
I was in Paris a couple of years ago, and that's the way they were dancing.
A couple of years ago, oui. But today, everyone does le twist.
Le twist?
Oui, le twist.
You think you could show it to us?
Perhaps. If the musicians can play the music.
Those musicians can play any style of music. Can't they, Jenny?
But not the music pour le twist.
Well, why don't we ask them? What are you trying to do? Scare them off?
I was playing it cool.
It's so cool, you almost froze the whole deal. Come on.
Here comes the poor man's hour. Ladies and gentlemen, the gracious Miss Clunker has persuaded Mr. Bergeon to demonstrate the latest dance craze from Paris, the twist. And he will demonstrate with Miss Watson.
If you can play it.
You've seen the new look, and you've heard the new sound. Now the Continental Twist, baby, is in your town. And let's twist, 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 twist to the Continental Twist. Oh, let's twist, twist, twist. Round and round, the dance hall floor. Come on and twist, twist, twist. Well, you're looking twisted. I want you to know, Continental from head to your soul. You're kind of dead. Keep twisting with your head for the music fit. Yeah.
ladies and gentlemen, just a minute. We'd like for you to relax and with your kind indulgence and attention, we'll do a little show for you. And, Bourgeois, hey, come here, Bourgeois. give me the tumble. Besides doing the twist, you can do the bone. Yeah. The little bone. Yeah. One, two, three. Nice ladies and gentlemen, from all parts of the globe, we want to tell you a little story about a trip Sam and me made. Me and Sam, we went on this long trip. We had our vacation about 3.5 months ago, and we decided to go
7 months ago.
About 7 months ago, we had this vacation.
14 years
ago. It was 22 years ago. We were little children, our mothers and fathers. Anyway, we went all the way to the Orient, and we had a lot of fun, a lot of surprises, and our biggest surprise came when the plane landed in Tel Aviv. That was a swinging place, Tel Aviv, and there was a couple of little cats from the hot club of Israel met us at the plane. One little fella had on a little skull cap, a headpiece, and the other cat was from Shul, because I just come from a cool Shul. He had a loaf of pumpernickel on the one arm, a string of Italian sausage in the other hand. He wasn't taking no chance. He says, I'd dig you two cats from Las Vegas, and they put us in a Jeep and brought us to the hotel, and, they give Sam a room, they give me a room, and about 6 o'clock that evening, I was in my room putting on my baby oil. And I heard a knock on the door, and it was him, and he was hollering, label up. I said, who's that? He said, Sam Malone. I said, what happened to you? He says, the little fellow with the pumpernickel invited us to a swinging place in the desert and said to get there real early. Well, folks, believe me, we had so much fun at this place. Sam came home, he wrote this little letter and sealed it in a little can and threw the can out in case anything happened to us on the way home. Somebody would find it and read about us. So this tells a story about
Read the letter. Read the letter. There, you wrote it, read it. Go ahead, read everything on it. All this. Watch when you come to a comma, you raise your voice. When you come to period, you drop. Two periods, you're on your own. Come on, tell them stuff. Come on, man.
They told us where, and off we went. And when we got there, it was a tent.
We gave the word.
And we gave the word. And they let us in. And all we did was give some skin. But we kept cooling, cooling. We were scared and we ain't fooling. But man, we soon regained control. Our password was...
Pasta Fazzola.
Upon a stand sat 40 cats, a crazy band, and turban hats, 13 drums, and 24 flutes, 39 French horns, and 2 goo-goos. Coolin', coolin', thinking we would get some schoolin'. The leader waved a lightning rod, and then there played.
God, tell him the story. This is the story.
The lights grew dim, and a chick came on. And she looked at him, and he was gone. I was a wreck, began to shake. Around her neck, she wore a snake. But we kept cooling, cooling, while she kept on a hooling. She called that snake by name, I swear, and the reptile's name was...
Lucky Pierre.
This crazy dame was flying sails, and around her frame were 7 veils. And as she danced, I bit my nails, and then she advanced and dropped 2 veils. With our eyes, he kept on dueling. She said to him,
take off more.
She never stopped and danced toward me. And then she dropped nail number 3. I told that frail, I'd dig that jive. And then she took off veil 4 and 5.
And we were rolling, rolling.
All at once we weren't cooling. There was no time for politics.
You only got one more to go, boy. Number six. Don't lose your place.
She reached my side, and I was in heaven. And then I cried, come on, 7!
He's laughing, but he ain't happy. Where will you hear the last part? Go ahead, read, Seymour.
The 7th veil concealed her face, and she took it off and played her ace. And we stopped rolling. All at once we weren't cooling. The chick who really was a mess turned out to be
Elliot Ness. Mamma mia, mi twistiare.
Twistiare, twistiare, twistiare.
Figgi mia, cutturare. Mamma mia, pensaccio tu.
Twistiare, twistiare, twistiare.
Sì, ci piglia, musicante, it va, it bene. Sempre lo twist, mano, te.
Twistiare, twistiare, twistiare.
Sì, ci piglia, fanno sia. Sempre lo twist, mano, te.
Oh, mamma.
Won't you do the twist for me?
Oh, mama, won't you do the twist for me?
Oh,
oh, mama, won't you do the twist for me?
Mama,
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 mama, mama,
won't you do the twist for me?
down that wants to see me.
I'm here.
I'm in the mail, man.
Oh.
Play something, Jack.
I think I'm a pretty good judge of a man's character. Now, just reinstate it. That's an order. Oh, Mr. Evans, I want to thank you for a most delightful evening.
Thank you, Your Honor.
If you want to thank anyone, it should be these two ladies. They've been telling me all about your troubles and what I should do about it.
Thank you very much, Miss Quinter.
It's quite all right, Louis.
They've convinced me to allow your club to reopen, and I just told the commissioner on the phone to restore your licenses at midnight.
Gee, that's wonderful. Thank you, sir, very much.
You haven't thanked Miss Watson yet.
Come in. Now I remember. I saw your picture.
Well, everyone did. It was in the newspaper when it was stolen.
Yeah, but I saw it at a tourist place. That other little cat was painting over it.
You mean Julius?
Yeah, that's the reason they slugged me that night. They didn't know when I saw it or not.
Are you sure,
I'm
Louis?
Positive.
Oh, Louis! I could kiss you.
Get me the police.
Oh, I'm so... I never, well, you see, I didn't... Oh! Come here.
Police.
Yeah, it's a foolproof scheme, he says. We can't get caught. By Aunt Wilhelmina's foot. I told you 1,000 times.
Oh, shut up, Julius. You want to know something? I'm going to tell them I didn't know I was painting over stolen pictures.
Tell them anything you like. You know, I still can't understand how they caught us.
I told you, just before you clapped that Evans over the head, he saw the Lady Elena.
But you'd already covered most of it. All he could see was her legs.
Well, a fellow like him, that's the first thing he notices.
Thank you very much. We appreciate your kindness.
They were really grooving.
Ladies and gentlemen, the grand reopening of our club was due to the fine efforts of our wonderful mayor and the patron of the arts, Letitia Clunker. And you are twisting here tonight because they did culture.
Louis.
What is it, baby?
I want to talk to you.
Well, don't whisper. Come on up here. These are all my friends. To tell you the truth, folks, I wouldn't be here tonight if it wouldn't be for this fine lady. What's on your fine, pretty mind?
Well, the streets are jammed with people wanting to do the twist.
Crazy.
And there's a contingent from the St. Social Club. Either you go out or they're coming in.
You hear that, Your Honor? The people are dancing on the streets. How about giving us permission for one of those old-fashioned
twisting block parties.
Hey! Permission granted.
How about that? Now let me and the boys go first, otherwise we'll never get out. And we're going to do a new arrangement for a fine group of youngsters. Oh, when the day,
oh, when the day,
for twisting him.